4, 5.
Hey, what's going on, everyone? I hope you guys are having a good weekend. This is a video filmed in downtown Toronto, starting off at Berczy Park and just checking out some of the streets. It's filmed on April 10th in the morning, just before 10 a.m. It was not a lot of people out because it's obviously in the morning on a Sunday. 5 degrees, so it's cool but not cold. And yeah, thanks for watching. Well, we are here in Berczy Park. It's down by Front Street, downtown in Toronto. This place is a big hit with dock walkers. You can see we got one dog there, second one there, third one up on the hill. I'm sure there's others in the area here that we don't quite see yet. You got the dog fountain here. Of course, it's not running, obviously, because it's just coming out of winter. There's some more dogs up that way there. So we got 4, 5, and 6, 7. Eight over there, 9. I'm not sure, I may have counted those ones, I'm not sure. It's a Sunday morning, so it's going to be pretty quiet right now, but that's fine. Not really sure what's going on here. It's used to be a sidewalk, but it looks like they've paved it with asphalt here, and they got the lines here. I don't know what they're doing, why they have these big blocks up here, what they're planning on it. just to give you guys more of a look all around the area here. So this place, it's called Brash and Sassy now. This used to be the old Pravda Russian vodka bar. Obviously with the whole thing that's going on in Russia with the Ukraine, apparently this place started getting a lot of problems. People were hating on them, saying all sorts of things. I mean, they got nothing to do with the conflict over there, but because they had the word Russian and they served a lot of vodka and stuff, people were hating on them, on the business owners, which, I mean, it's kind of idiotic to me. It's unfortunate. Person has nothing to do with what's happening over there, but people started causing problems and they ended up having to rebrand altogether. It's really too bad. They're just trying to make ends meet. Like I said, they have nothing to do with it, but that's kind of the world we live in nowadays. People online just full of anger and wanting to display it to people. So this RC coffee Robo Cafe. Oh, cool. I've never seen this. Robo Cafe. You get to, I guess, choose your own coffees from here. That's kind of neat. I'm going to have to try that sometime. I know I'm not going to do it today, but I'll be able to try it. Just to see what it's like. I've got a mocha with me right now, so I'm about to buy a second one from there, but that's kind of neat. There's also apparently a restaurant, not in Toronto. There's a restaurant in Japan, apparently, that's completely robotic. Like, there's not a person in there. I don't know how the food gets prepared. It's all just instant food, maybe. But, yeah, it might be fine to check out sometime. If I ever go traveling overseas and see Japan again. So, score on King, now hiring for all positions. Excuse me. Just belched. If anyone's looking for a job, they're hiring for all positions there. Looks like a bar/restaurant, so if you need a job, have a look.
Oh, so just as a little bit of side news, not that this is important or anything, but sports betting is legal in Ontario, well, in Canada as well, but in Ontario, they've opened up a bunch of online stuff. My old Bet365 account, I'm now betting on, and managed to grow it from $45 up to $190. So, taking it slow and see how I can do with it. It's fun. Makes sports so much more exciting. Actually, the funny thing, I've been able to do well on the point spread betting against the Lakers. So, sorry, LeBron. You didn't even make the playoff, the play-in tournament. I'm actually not even a big basketball fan, so. So I'm sure you guys know this, but Toronto's got, in the downtown core, anywhere in the area, they've got all sorts of little neighborhoods and districts. They got some signs here. So you've got the financial district that way, St. Mark's, the Garden District up ahead, and Old Town Toronto. Golden Tie, I think they're closed now. I think they shut down. I could be wrong. I thought I'd read that they'd shut down. I've been to this restaurant years and years ago. Like a decade ago. But I don't think they're open anymore. Church in Richmond now selling. For anybody who has $750,000 to spend on a studio, maybe I can make that with my sports betting. I'm just kidding. I have no idea how much those units cost, but downtown Toronto is going to be a hell of a lot of money. Thank you. weird weather. It was, I mean, we're in April for crying out now. Yesterday we had hail come down, a lot of hail. It was this is the weirdest thing. I was out yesterday. I didn't do any videos though. Oh, Sunset Grill. Breakfast food. I love breakfast food. Says on the bus, Detroit, Michigan. So I guess if you wanted to smuggle yourself across the border, you could try hiding in the cargo hold there. That's wide open. Probably not going to be a very comfortable ride though. Now let's walk down through here. Just walking through the guess the under the parking drop-off area for the Sheraton Hotel. Done that. It's not like I haven't done that myself out in public. He's having a rough time too. Yeah, that's why I stopped having martinis for breakfast. No. Can anybody guess where that mural is from? It's from a TV show. If you can guess what that's from, write it in the comments. Take a guess if anybody knows. guess we'll see how this summer turns out, if everything's going to return back to normal, or to a semblance of normalcy. It'd be nice to see patios and restaurants open like they used to be before, but who knows? They're already talking about saying, oh, there's another wave that's hit in Ontario, and
I'm going to go to the hospital.
Uh-oh, Maserati got a parking ticket.
Getting a selfie.
Alright guys, well we're down at Front Street here, and I think I'm going to cut the video here. I'm going to head back up here and do a little bit of shopping. Thanks for watching, I'll catch you at the next video.